Good morning. This is Brett T. Evans. I am live at the New York Auto Show. We are just waiting for the Jeep press conference to start. You can tell back in that shadowy space, we've got the Trackhawk just waiting to be revealed live. But until then, we're just going to hang out. So stay with us. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, and I will be sure to answer them once the press conference is over. Thank you so much for watching, and please be sure to stay tuned.
Please welcome head of Jeep brand, Mike Manley.
Well, good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us. Well, last year, the Jeep brand celebrated its 75th anniversary, and what a milestone for us it was. That was 75 years of being part of our customers' journey in their pursuit of freedom, adventure, and exploration. As I've often said, the Jeep brand is more than just a collection of class-leading SUVs. We represent a spirit to do more tomorrow than we did today. It's a spirit that our customers embody, and it's a spirit that I believe is universal. Now, Jeep is one of the few brands that has been shaped more by its customers than it has by the corporations that have owned it. Now, our job is to listen. Understand our customers' hopes and dreams, give them what they want, and then get out of their way. And as a result, we've enjoyed considerable growth over the last few years. Just 7 years ago, we sold around 300,000 units. Now, since then, we've enjoyed consecutive year-over-year increases, including five global sales records, and delivered over 1.4 million vehicles in 2016. So, I know you're all waiting for that. But before we get to that, I'm just going to give you a quick brand overview of how we're doing this year. And so far, through the first quarter, global sales are really in line with our expectations. Our regional performances outside and after are very strong, frankly. APAC is up 41%. EMEA up 12%, LATAM up 22% year over year. And these results are offsetting our expected reduction here in the US as we switch over to our new Compass and reduce our fleet sales considerably. The good news is the new Compass has just started to arrive in our US dealerships. So expect the numbers to continue to improve throughout the year as we complete the global rollout of this important vehicle. Now remember, Compass is entering one of the largest and fastest growing segments in the world. Now, I'm clearly excited about our new Compass, which in my view stands out as a segment leader none can match because of its combination of best-in-class 4x4 capability, excellent on-road driving dynamics, and a premium design. And I think it's worth noting that this winning formula is one we perfected on the most awarded SUV ever, the Jeep Grand Cherokee. Now, the Grand Cherokee forever shifted consumers' expectations by delivering legendary Jeep capability matched to premium ride comfort and confident road handling. Now, you may recall it was here in New York we introduced the 2017 Grand Cherokee Trailhawk. Now, that's a moniker that designates the highest off-road level of capability. Well, you may not have noticed that at the same time, we're already working on another version of class-leading capability. But this time, we were pushing capability in a different direction. What if we set out to design the most powerful, quickest SUV ever? If you like, the ultimate performance SUV. And if you know your Jeep heritage, you'll recall that we've had this thought before. Firstly, with the 1998 Grand Cherokee ZJ, which was powered by the 5.9-litre V8. Now, this SUV recorded a 0-60 time in an impressive 6.8 seconds. Well, it was impressive back then. Then we followed that with the first Grand Cherokee SRT in 2006, which travelled 0-60 in 4.8 seconds, so a little bit better. But that was still a different time, and the concept of a performance SUV has significantly moved on. So to compete and stand out in today's world, we would have to produce something truly special. Something that would put a smile on your face just to think of the concept. And I know it's rare for me, but you see the smile. But ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce the most powerful and the quickest SUV ever, the 2018 Jeep Grand Cherokee Trailhawk. Supercharged 6.2-litre V8 that delivers 707 horsepower at 645 foot-pound of torque. And as you saw, I think that translates to some pretty impressive numbers for on-track performance. We're obviously talking 0-60 in 3.5 seconds, taking a quarter mile in 11.6 seconds, and reaching a top speed of around 180 miles an hour. Now, lateral acceleration is also track-worthy, measuring 0.88 g on the skid pad. So in my view, this is the ultimate performance SUV and one of the fastest ways I know to put a smile on your face. Now, the performance numbers are only part of the story. It took our renowned SRT engineering team to beef everything up, ensuring the entire chassis system is optimized to handle all that power. The Torque Flight 8-speed automatic transmission and driveline components engineered to handle serious torque responsibly and reliably. The transmission software was programmed to determine the appropriate shift map to handle a range of on-track driving variables like kickdown events and longitudinal and lateral acceleration. Traport features a performance-tuned version of our five-mode select track system. Now in track mode, shift times are more than twice as quick, and the torque split sends most of the power to the rear wheels. Stability control, suspension stiffness, and steering systems are also calibrated to meet driver preferences. But in addition to that, Traport offers a custom mode, which accommodates drivers who want to create their own personal settings. The Bilstein adaptive suspension complements the chassis setup with extensive use of high-strength, lightweight aluminum components. Now, this helps manage the unsprung weight to deliver confident ride and handling on your favorite road or your racetrack. Now, standard 20 by 10 inch lightweight aluminum wheels are fitted with speed-rated Pirelli tires. And note how the wheels form those signature yellow Brembo brake calipers. And in front, you'll find the largest ever brakes on a Jeep SUV with two-piece vented rotors and six-piston calipers. It's all part of a comprehensive system that delivers outstanding stopping performance, heat management, and durability. And all of that can bring this Traport from 60 miles an hour to zero in just 114 feet. Now, for uncompromised straight-line acceleration, our standard launch control features puts everything in readiness at the touch of a button. And this includes a torque reserve system which minimizes manifold filling time to deliver instantaneous torque from a standing stop. And that's obviously everything under the skin. Now, aesthetically, your first clue that this Traport is no ordinary Grand Cherokee is evident even when it's standing still. The front hood, as you can see, is sculpted with dual heat extractors, and that hints at the more than 700 horses stabled inside. While air induction modules replace fog lamps to enhance air intake and optimize engine cooling. And you may have noticed on the rear, it showcases the 4-inch black chrome quad exhaust tips. I know they look impressive. That's nothing compared to what they sound like. Now inside the driver-focused interior, you'll find premium materials throughout. The 3-spoke race-inspired steering wheel has a flat bottom and paddle shifters. The Uconnect touchscreen in the center stack serves up the latest in-car technology, including Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Plus, we've added performance pages, giving drivers quick access to an array of performance timers and gauge readouts. And there's even an engine dyno screen that measures instantaneous horsepower, torque, and current transmission gear. This also comes with a snapshot function so that drivers can save their readouts on a USB drive to track and compare performance telemetry. Now, as quick and powerful as this Grand Cherokee Traport is, it is first and foremost a Jeep. So it comes equipped with more than 70 safety and security features, which you can see listed in big, bold print behind me. One of the things I find amazing is it does all of this, and it can still tow 7,200 pounds. You know, some days this job is especially enjoyable, and today I genuinely wouldn't be anywhere else. Because this is the Jeep that calls out to the inner race car driver we all thought we could be. The new Grand Cherokee Traport delivers outstanding performance numbers and is tangible proof of what happens when Jeep can do meets SRT know-how. So there you have it. I'd like to sincerely thank you all for your time.
Ladies and gentlemen, please hold a moment for Prince Photography.
they're all big kids. People play with them. Julia.
Alright, stay with me. I'm going to put the phone down for just a second, but stay with me and we'll get some, get up close with the Jeep. Just a moment. Sorry about that. We're going to get up close with this here Trackhawk. So unfortunately, with the phone that I'm using, I can't actually access your comments. So I'm gonna just hopefully get a high-level overview of the truck, and then we can get to some of your comments. Once I go off Facebook Live, I'll respond to some of your comments personally. So for those of you who are just joining, we're live at the Jeep Grand Cherokee Trackhawk press conference, the 2017 New York International Auto Show. They started the press conference in a pretty dramatic fashion. They, as you can see, they have this Trackhawk situated on a four-wheel dyno, and they had someone in the car, and she brought it slowly up to speed, and then right at the end of the press video, she gunned it, and we got to hear how glorious this thing sounds. Some fantastic supercharger whine. The exhaust note is amazing. It was fantastic. And the best part was, after she kind of slowed down and brought it back down to a stop and the press conference resumed, the entire hall just was filled with this great, you know, the smell of performance. Some nice exhaust smell. So that was kind of fun. But it was a cool way to start the show. Glad they did that. This thing sounds great. It looks great. And it's definitely takes Jeep performance to a whole new level. In just a moment, I'm gonna wait for some people to get out of the way, and then I'll show you some of the things that make this Trackhawk different from a regular Jeep SRT. We learned in the press conference that they will take this thing from 60 to 0 in 114 feet, which is a number that is about as good as a lot of the things that come with a Porsche badge. So that's pretty impressive. The other external visual cue that you get that this is a Trackhawk is right back here. The Jeep SRT has two large bazooka-sized exhaust pipes. The Trackhawk has four. It's got a quad exhaust outlet, and we got to hear it, and it sounded great. It's fantastic. And then front. Sorry, in the scrum of it. Let's see if we can get you guys a good shot of the front.
Are you Facebook Live too? It's my first live video.
Oh, enjoy it.
I feel like I'm part of like the 21st century.
Welcome. So up front, the only obvious cue you get is the front air intakes have been replaced. The front fog lights have been replaced with air intakes. Otherwise, the front fascia is exactly what you get in the rest of the 2017 Grand Cherokee SRT lineup. That was just updated this year, so you get that kind of that cool mail slot front intake underneath the Jeep 7-slot grille. But with the Trackhawk, you don't get fog lights, you get air intakes instead. That's to feed more air to that 6.2-liter supercharged heavy engine. Same engine found in the Hellcat, 707 horsepower. It's a really, really impressive piece of machinery.
When I get a little bit closer.
Here at the New York International Auto Show.
So there's the interior. It's a pretty fantastic machine. So in addition to the exterior changes, the interior is revised as well. That's Napa leather, so that's a very high grade of leather. You can upgrade from Napa to a different, a higher grade of leather. I love that red. Check in and see if we can answer any questions for you. Joe Kwong, yes, this is a Jeep. Josh Taylor, I don't anticipate an electric version of this in this generation. However, Jeep and Lexus are more pricey. They are committed to improving emissions and fuel consumption in all their vehicles. And so, turbo version. So the supercharger doesn't do it for you?
Because the Hellcat.
Let me show you what that looks like. That is a 6.2-liter supercharged Hemi V8, 707 horsepower, 645 pound-feet of torque, I think. Pretty fantastic. That is a twin rotor supercharger. Really good response, really good. Obviously no lag in the belt with the supercharger, so you're just going to get really impressive performance out of that. Can't really tell in the lighting, but there is Trackhawk embroidery on the front seats. Or I believe that's embossed leather, actually, not embroidered. Really, really nice. And there's your cockpit. You know, otherwise very similar to the Grand Cherokee SRT, just slightly more premium.
Deep into the 11s, all right? And I know my boy Mike Galliano is going to get these things into the 11s.
There's that Brembo Performance brake system. Slotted rotors the size of a pizza.
Righty. So,
come back over to the dyno and give you guys another look at the truck before we call it a day.
That's okay.
There it is. One more time.
We're gonna get
Scott Powell.
Thank you all for joining us. Again, my name is Brett T. Evans with Truck Trend Magazine, coming live from the New York Auto Show. Keep asking questions, and I'll be happy to respond to them off of Facebook Live. But if you have any questions for me, please feel free to ask. And then you can also find our press coverage of the Trackhawk on trucktrend.com. And so if you have any questions about that story, feel free to ask us, and we'll be sure to answer the questions as quickly as we can. You can join us live in a few more hours today. We're going to be sitting down with some of the chief engineers of the Jeep Grand Cherokee Trackhawk. So join us live. If you have any questions, please ask them here, and we'll be sure to ask them to the engineers. And thank you all for joining us. Good being here with you.